Welcome back. So winter means soup season, right? Nice comfort food, nice warm bowl of soup. Our dear friend Leanne Miller sharing a recipe for creamy Italian soup. It's recently been a huge hit with your family, right?
It has.
We're looking at it now. It looks so amazing.
It's so good. You know, this time of year in Ohio, we all just want that cozy, warm, hearty food. So we've got a bowl for you ready already.
Great, thank you. Well, it is Italian soup, and you have your bow tie pasta in there.
I do. I'm not a, I don't think I have a lick of Italian in me, but I sure do love their soup.
I know. I sure do love everything about it, right?
I have Amish country in me, but just maybe. Now, that is hot Italian sausage. So most of your places, I got my hot Italian sausage yesterday at Walnut Creek Cheese, and it's in the casing, so it's a sausage. Mm-hmm. It's not smoked, it's raw. And I just took my kitchen shears and just went down the center, and you just take it out of the casing.
Right.
If you can't find it in the bulk, okay?
Okay,
so this is
about
amazing. Isn't it amazing?
Let's start
that.
Now we need to start from the beginning, because we started at the end.
Let's
Sorry about that.
Rewind.
She hands it to me. I'm not going to not eat any, right? Okay, so we start with your sausage. Did you add any spice to it too, or no?
Well, that's what's beautiful about this. A lot of your spice is
it's already in it.
Italian sausage taking care of it. But there is a teaspoon of oregano, a cup of onions minced, and I like to use my slap chopper.
I love that too.
Yeah, I'm not fancy. I'm not a fancy chef. I don't carry my knives with me. I carry my slap chopper.
That's all you need.
Yeah, so, and then about 3 tablespoons of garlic, minced garlic, because our family loves minced garlic. And I just get this. Just get the jar.
That's great.
If you don't have time to hand press and mince your garlic, that way, this is wonderful
stuff. That's great. All right, okay, so this is what this looks like. Wow, look at that.
Done, okay.
Right?
And Jenny helped me strain this. So you're gonna strain your extra drippings. I like to call them drippings.
Drippings, yes.
Strain those off.
Okay.
And then we're ready for our next steps.
All right, sounds good. What's next?
Beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna have you pour that in there.
Okay.
And tip, set the jar down in, like to the side, yep, and then tip. Then you don't spill, you don't get it on you, you
splash
don't spill down
everywhere.
Your stove that you have to clean it up later.
Right.
Okay, so we're putting that in.
Okay, like then, the tip. So that's just chicken broth.
48-ounce can.
Okay.
Collagen. Love
Huge.
It. Okay, teaspoon of salt and garlic salt. And then, you know, I don't know if everybody knows this, but Amish country is so popular for their bulk food.
Yes.
And yes, so I got all these yesterday at Walnut Creek Cheese. There's oregano in this, there's garlic salt. I mean, look at that amount.
And they separate
salt.
The little nuts and everything too,
oh, yes,
how
I
you
love
want
that.
To do it.
And then this is the Parmesan cheese, and this is to serve on your soup.
At the end?
At the end.
Yes, got it. Am I putting all of this in here?
You're putting it
the
all
soup,
in.
Or the salt, okay. Garlic salt and regular salt.
Then we have some lovely sun-dried tomatoes. These, I also love these dried. These are a dried sun-dried tomato. They're not in liquid.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Okay.
Okay, so I chopped them really fine because I don't want a big piece of sun-dried tomato in my bite. I want like a minced piece. Okay, and then we've got a cup of extra sharp cheddar cheese going in.
Looks good.
I'm gonna turn this up a little bit.
Turn it up, let's melt that cheese.
And then we've got our heavy whipping cream. Now, Amish country and their heavy whipping cream. This has a tablespoon,
I figured it'd have like 7 sticks of butter
You're
or something,
like,
so now I know why it tastes so good.
Here we go. So there's a tablespoon of flour in here, just a tablespoon.
Really?
I just want a tiny bit of thickening.
To thick it up a little bit.
Yeah, just a little
like
bit.
Like that? Okay.
Okay, so that's going in, and that's going to give it, once you start stirring that sesh, you're going to see, that's going to give it its beautiful creamy color. And then those sun-dried tomatoes with the hot sausage, it's just kind of giving it this wonderful color. I love the color.
I was just
going
to say that. It is beautiful.
Okay, now, because I know that they'll come for soup.
Okay, wait, while people are looking at this because Ben put this up. So I text you almost every weekend.
Yeah,
so I'm
you
like,
do.
This weekend we made your peanut butter energy balls, which Sienna loves them. So I just put them each in a baggie because mine's a lot bigger than yours were.
Yeah, yours are
They're like softballs. And then just Sunday morning, I made your French toast that you brought up.
With that Walnut Creek cheese cinnamon toast bread.
So good.
You know you can get that at Mark's.
I didn't know Mark's. I knew there there's some places that sell it here.
So you can go locally to Mark's.
Amazing. So I make all that stuff that you give us, and then those energy balls are fantastic. I keep them in baggies in the freezer. Every morning, Sienna grabs one on the way to school. They're so good.
They are so good.
Okay, and they last.
They do. So now you're adding our pasta.
Okay, so this is...
Oh, you're not done.
This started... I told Wayne before the segment that this started as a keto recipe, but I got to carb it up. I mean, that's just... Okay. I just do.
It's our
job. This is a no-judgment zone here.
This is 3 cups of bow tie pasta. Now, let me tell you a trick about this. I want to show... Tell me where to show. This is how I like to store my pasta. I get a container just like this. Yeah. Once I take it off the stove, I rinse it with hot water to get some of the gluten off of it. And then I put some garlic olive oil.
Oh, good.
And then I can store it like that, and it's lovely.
Okay, and it doesn't get, they don't stick together. That's
right,
perfect.
Exactly.
There you go.
I just have one question. Will this be ready before the show's over?
Right there's your bowl. Yeah. Right?
Oh, that's Christy's bowl.
No.
It has her name written all over it.
No, take it.
No.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay.
Okay. Don't tell her more than twice.
One quick thing. Pick up that empty bag.
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
So this is the kale. I like to strip. Okay, so watch. Okay. I'm going to strip.
We're negative 10 seconds.
Okay, strip your beans. Chop them up.
Go.
And then we're going to.
So you're adding kale in.
Kale last.
We have the recipe on our website, foxate.com, so you don't miss anything. Leanne, we love you.
Is that good?
You're awesome.
Okay, I'm going to
try it. We're going to get another bowl for you.
Oh, my gosh.
He's going to get it.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.